Hi, and welcome to Tempus's Virtual Help Center. My name is Tempe. I'll be your virtual guide. Congratulations. You are now the new owner of an electronic device acquired through the EVV Device Voucher Program. Today, I'm going to walk you through setting up your EVV device from the start. You can pause this video at any time to follow along with me step by step, or watch all the way through and set up your device on your own. Remember, you can always watch this video several times if you need to. Before we start, make sure you have access to a Wi-Fi network and that your device is fully charged. The power button is located on the right side of the device. Press and hold down that button for 3 seconds and release. This will turn your device on. Once your device is on, it will prompt you to select a different language if English isn't your preferred language. Tap the Start button to continue to the next step. The device will now need to be connected to your Wi-Fi. Tap Skip at the lower left-hand corner of the screen to allow the device to search for Wi-Fi connections nearby. Be sure to know the name of your Wi-Fi and the password as you'll need to enter them into the prompts. Select your Wi-Fi by tapping on the name of your Wi-Fi network name. Now enter the password of your network so the device can connect to it. Tap the Show Password box so you can see what you're typing. This makes entering the password much easier. When you have finished entering the password, tap the word Connect to connect your Wi-Fi network. The device must be connected to a Wi-Fi to complete the setup. You're now ready to set up your Google account. If you already have a Google account or Gmail account, you can use that to sign in here. However, if you don't, you'll need to set up a new account by tapping the Create an Account, then select For My Personal Use. Type in your first and last name. Tap Next when done. Now enter your birthday and select your gender. Here is where you will need to set up a Gmail account. Type in the name of the email address you would like to use. When done, tap the Next button and create a new password. Be sure to keep this information on hand as you will need it again to check our email later on. If you don't already have an email address, then you can use this one going forward. However, if you would rather use an email address you already have, you will still need to set up a Gmail account and watch the other video that shows you how to add your other email address to this device. At the next prompt, you'll be asked if you want to add a phone number to this device. Simply tap Skip at the bottom since you don't need to do this. Next, review your account name to be sure it's correct and tap the Next button. Next, be sure to read the Privacy and Terms Agreement and scroll to the bottom and tap I agree when done. Then, tap Confirm on the confirmation pop-up. Your device will take a few moments to set up and continue to the final steps. Now scroll to the bottom of the Google service page and tap Accept. Now you'll need to set up a 4-digit passcode. It's very important to be sure you remember this for later so you can access the device. On the following two screens that prompt you to use Google Assistant, you can tap Skip at the bottom and then tap No Thanks. Congratulations! Your device is ready to use. Just a reminder, the on and off button is located on the right side. Press it once to see the options to turn it off. The buttons above that are for the device volume. Thanks for watching. I hope this video helped walk you through the steps to set up your device. The next step is to set up your EVV account when you receive your welcome email. Keep in mind that this device is not a phone, therefore there is no phone number associated with this device, and you cannot use it to make calls. Until next time, bye for now.